Hi, Chuck Huber here for the Stata YouTube channel. I'd like to show you how to analyze data that were collected using a complex survey sampling design. I'm going to assume that you are already familiar with Stata's survey set command. If you are not, you might want to watch the videos that describe survey set before continuing with this video. Let's begin by opening some example data. Let's click File here at the top left and scroll down to Example Data Sets. And we're going to click Stata 13 Manual Data Sets. Then we'll select Survey Data Reference Manual. And we're going to select NHANES2.DTA here near the top by clicking Use. And if you'll need a web connection for to download these data. So I'm going to close this window. And let's take a quick look at our data by describing it. Let's go to Data, Describe, Describe Data in Memory or File. And I'm just going to click OK because I'd like to see a description of all of the data. This is a nice clean data set of the NHANES data, National Health and Nutrition Examination Survey. It's included with Stata from across the web, and this is a nice clean version of the data. And here we have just a treasure trove of information about people. We have variables like age, height, weight, systolic blood pressure, diastolic blood pressure, cholesterol, and so forth. Lots and lots of data in here. But one of the nice things about this data set is that it has already been survey set for us. So let's go to Statistics, scroll down to Survey Data Analysis, Setup and Utilities, and select Declare Survey Design for Data Set. And these data have already had the sampling characteristics defined for us. So we can click on Weights and see that the sample weights are already defined for us. So we can close that. And so this will allow us to begin analyzing our data. We're ready to go. Stata has a large collection of features for analyzing data from complex survey designs. Again, they're located under Statistics, Survey Data Analysis, and we can create tables, we can calculate means, proportions, ratios, and so forth. We can fit a variety of linear models. We can fit models for binary outcomes using logistic, probit, and other kinds of models. We can fit models for ordinal outcomes, including ordered logit and probit. Stata can handle categorical outcomes using multinomial logistic, probit, and other features. Count outcomes can be modeled with Poisson and negative binomial regression, as well as variations on those. Stata can fit Cox proportional hazards models and parametric survival models for survival data, as well as endogenous covariate models, instrumental variables, Tobit and probit regression, as well as sample selection models such as Heckman and probit and ordered probit models, as well as generalized linear models. Let's click this and take a look at this dialog box. So again, we can fit a wide variety of models using the Stata's survey features. So let's go back to Statistics and go to Survey Data Analysis, and let's just do some simple things. For instance, we might be interested in calculating the mean of age, for example. So let's select age, and I'm just going to click OK. And now the results tell me that the mean age in this population is 42.25. Now standard errors have been corrected for all of the characteristics of our sample, including the strata and sampling units and sample weights and so forth. We might be interested in looking at a proportion. So let's go back and go to Survey Data Analysis. And we might want to see the proportion of males and females, for example. So we could select sex, click OK. And we can see that the proportion of males is approximately 48% rounded, and the proportion of females is approximately 52% rounded. And we can see our linearized standard errors and confidence intervals for these. We might want to look at cross tabs. So we could go back to Statistics, Survey Data Analysis. We might want to look at a two-way table of perhaps sex and race. And we can click OK. And then we can see the proportions of males and females by race in our population. Or we might want to start looking at things such as height. Let's go back to Survey Data Analysis. We might want to see if the mean height is the same in males and females. Might be something else we might like to do. Let's remove age here. And I want to do that. I'm going to click the If In Over tab. And then I'm going to select sex and click OK. And now I can see the average height in males and females along with their linearized standard errors and confidence intervals. And I might like to fit some models, so I could go back to statistics, survey data analysis, and let's go to linear models, select linear regression. And I might like to fit a model for systolic blood pressure, BP systolic. And maybe I'd like to look at that by age, for example, maybe age and weight as predictor variables. I can click OK. And I can fit my model. And again, notice that the standard errors are based on the linearized standard errors. So we've taken into account the complex survey design in the calculation of our standard errors. We could also do something like logistic regression, survey data analysis, binary outcomes. We could select logistic regression reporting odds ratios. And maybe we'll select diabetes as our outcome, yes or no. And for our independent variables, maybe we could select the same variables as age and weight, for example. And when I click OK, again, Stata runs my logistic regression model using the linearized standard errors, and I can see my results in terms of odds ratios. Okay, so we can fit lots and lots of different kinds of models, tabulate our data, and do all kinds of analyses. And Stata will take into account the features of our complex survey data. Okay, so I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.